design of steel structures as per IS 800 code. Steel used in construction of various engineering projects such as industrial buildings, offshore oil rigs, pressure vessel, railway lines, bridges, etc. Various studies says that around 50% of the manufactured steel used in construction of the steel structures. The major advantage of the steel is eco-friendly. Around 98% of steel are reused. So this clearly indicates that sustainability of the steel structures. All across the industries around the globe, there is an increasing demand for steel structures. So this is one of the typical example that steel is very important material in construction industry. So optimum design and cutting edge technologies in construction is key for the steel projects. This course is developed for diploma and undergraduate civil structural engineering students, also for practicing engineers. Many of the examples are presented in this course with principles of steel design as per IS 800 code. Design of steel structures. The major components. First chapter has given an introduction to the steel structures, section classifications and material grades and partial safety factors and advantages and disadvantages of the steel structures compared to the other materials. In the next chapter, we discussed about the design of connections. One of the key design aspects need to be considered in the design structures, because connections plays the major role in design of steel structures. Then the tension members, compression members, capacity calculations, similarly the flexural members, and finally subject to the combined forces. Come to the tension members. Tension member is one of the structural member in a structure which subjected to the tension, axial tension. So the main tension member capacity, it depends upon the three aspects. One is yielding of the cross section, is based on the gross area, and rupture of the cross section. Rupture always falls in the critical section where the section is weak, most probably in the connecting parts. Similarly for the block shear capacities. So we can estimate these capacities, and there are several examples has been illustrated, including the connection design, to calculate the tension capacity in this chapter. Come to the next chapter is compression members. So compression member is one of the structural element where the member is subjected to compression force. In typically, you know, most of the compression members like a columns, we make it as a vertical, we call it as a vertical compression member in a structure. A compression member in a roof truss is called as a strut or rafter. Columns are classified into two types. One is a short column, another one is long column. So short column, normally the capacities can be calculated based on the crushing and pure compression, whereas a long column has a tendency to buckle, so we need to estimate the buckling load as well. In order to estimate the buckling load, one should identify the given cross section. Is it plastic, compact, semi-compact or slender? So based on these categories, we can estimate the relevant sectional properties to calculate the section properties. However, the same compression members also will depends on supporting conditions. Based on the supporting conditions, the buckling factor will be given by most of the course can be multiplied by the length of the member, so that your buckling length will be estimated. So this also will be estimated based on the end conditions, the way we have been connected. So the connections also will play the major role in compression design as well. That means if you are tightly connected, that means fixed, right? If it is a welded connection, means both sides has been fixed. If it is a bolted connections, then we need to further estimate how the rotations or maybe the end conditions behaves based on your conditions, connections. So this is another factor need to be considered for compression design. The lastly, beam design. The beam is actually, we normally call it as the secondary beams and main beams. The reason behind that, how this has been connected and how the design principles can be applied. So majority of the course straight away has given a formulas to estimate the beam capacities based on the laterally supported beam and laterally unsupported beam. We can discuss more in detail how this the types of beams can be estimated, the capacities in detail in the chapter itself. So thank you for everyone.